Hello and welcome to Tea Time. I'm Chaiti Narula. We're at Clover Greens at Bangalore. What a beautiful golf course indeed. We're at hole number 14, par 5. And joining me today on the show to discuss the IT sector and the forecast for the year 2014 going forward is the CEO and Managing Director of Mindtree.
On the show this week, we have Krishna Kumar Natarajan, MD and CEO, Mindtree.
Every application and technology today, there is an enormous amount of sophistication which has come in, which really protects individual data as well as privacy.
In news, Jimmy Walker wins his second PGA Tour title by one shot at the Sony Open in Hawaii. And Louis Oosthuizen has claimed his second Volvo Golf Champions title at Durban Country Club.
What a beautiful tee off. Krishna Kumar Natarajan, welcome to Tea Time.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be on this program.
Now, is this your home course or is there any other course that you love to play?
I love to play at the Karnataka Golf Association. That's a modified course, has really been made to PGA standards.
Is that also happens to be your home course, is it?
That's my home course.
You're living the ideal life any
yes.
CEO would want to live today.
Absolutely.
So let's start off with the information technology. Let's hit the brass tracks with that. What are your top trends, in your opinion, for the year 2014 going forwards in the IT sector?
See, the IT sector is certainly experiencing a big change. Yeah. If you look at the Indian IT industry, from being driven from a cost arbitrage basis on which the business is done, increasingly IT companies are becoming the transformation partners of their customers. So some of the new disruptive trends which are happening, typically it's called SMAC, which is social, mobility, analytics and cloud.
Sure.
Those are starting to get adopted by enterprises in a big way. And I do believe in 2014, that's certainly going to drive a lot of demand for IT companies.
What is the conspicuous change that we will see from what we saw in the year 2013 and as we transcend towards 2014? What is that one change that you're going to see in the year going forward?
I think the big change as companies are concerned is that they need to start becoming experts in whatever services they deliver.
Right.
Which is why at Mindtree, we sort of repositioned ourselves to be an expertise-led, culture-backed company about 2 years back.
Okay.
We engaged a global branding company called Siegel & Gale.
Right.
So Siegel & Gale spoke to our customers, spoke to prospective Mindtree minds, and then came up with this positioning of being expertise-led.
Right.
Because increasingly, customers want us to bring in cost competitiveness, but beyond that, they clearly want us to be experts.
Sure.
And really solve business problems. So that's a big transition which is happening as far as the market is concerned. And we do believe in the future, the industry is going to be more of what you could call an order-making industry, where you're really going to the customer, telling him, hey, this is the problem, and this is how we'll solve it. From being an order-taking industry, that's how we've sort of evolved. And that's really the big transformation
change
which at Mindtree we're going through currently.
So good to know that's the metamorphosis that you're going through at Mindtree. Now, are companies today socially smart? And when I say socially smart, I'm obviously referring to the social media movement that we're seeing.
Right. I think it's becoming a very important part. In fact, we are investing heavily in what we call a next generation delivery platform, which will really help us become far more productive. But if you look at the interface of that, it is very much a social media driven interface, so that people connect with their colleagues, they connect to their friends. When they encounter a problem, they have friends helping them out. So the whole notion internally of social media is very, very important for organizations to be successful. It's not just on the internal front, but if you go to the external market-facing side,
sure.
Today a lot of customers try and get their views on organizations through their friends in the social media. So you need to be very active, be it on Facebook or business-oriented social sites like LinkedIn, so that customers get a feel of what is it you are and what offering you have in the marketplace.
All right, on that note, time now for me to tee off.
Absolutely. Nice shot.
Thank you. So now the big data buzz has been around for a while, but many organizations really don't know how to tap into the tremendous amount of big data that they collect. Mm-hmm. How would you advise companies to embrace big data better?
See, I think the key element is to understand what really is the implication of big data.
Big data.
With a very large car rental company with whom we have been working for 15 years, today, based on the preferences which their customers have, it's helping them to have far more connect with their customers. Just to give you a very simple example, based on preferences which a consumer has done once after booking, you're able to connect it in terms of next time around when he comes, what is the type of car he wants, what are the accessories which he wants, is there a key additional accessory which he prefers. So you sort of feed in things saying, hey, we know you came and took this from us. This time around, we're going to give you a 20% discount on that, which means it really enhances the connect with the customers.
Sure.
So essentially, the way at which at Mindtree we see big data is that the opportunities are huge. Mm-hmm. And particularly, if you think in the future that every device is going to be internet-enabled, the ability of big data to really play a role in transforming your association with consumers and your customers is going to dramatically change the way in which organizations think of leveraging big data. So it's not just a technology piece. I think it's important to understand how would you use it in the context of business, which is very
important.
To
your advantage, more so. All right, so India is, of course, riding on the big data wave. On that note, it's a good time now for us to take a break on Tea Time. We will stay in conversation with the CEO and Managing Director of Mindtree and discuss the IT sector in much more detail. Take a break. We will see you on the other side. Welcome back. And on this segment, let's discuss whether really the information security genie is out of the bottle or not. Mm-hmm. Will it be increasingly difficult now to tell from a friend or foe, as networks are now building artificial intelligence as well? I mean, let's not forget the whistleblowers, let's not forget the cyber surveillance that is taking place. What is your take on that?
See, I think the technologies which are today available to secure networks as well as servers and private data is extremely sophisticated.
Sure.
Again, going back to the example which I shared with you earlier in terms of Aadhaar, when we built the application, after the enrollment is done, when the data gets transmitted to the main data center, it's completely encrypted. So to that extent, even if there's a sophisticated hacker who really wants to access the data, there'll be no way he can do it. Also, we've incorporated several application innovations in terms of even when you send the packet, you segregate the core information, which is the name and the thing, from his biometric and iris scan sort of data. And that is also an encrypted form. So it gets reassembled back at the main data center. So every application and technology today, there is an enormous amount of sophistication which has come in, which really protects individual data as well as privacy. So I don't think, unless there is a human error or somebody who knows and willingly sort of compromises on the data, the chances that security will fail is extremely low.
We're going to discuss the e-commerce wave also in much detail, whether the brick and mortar is, of course, a passe or not. But before that, we've got a chip shot to finish. Come.
Absolutely.
So now, are we headed to kill the bricks and mortar model because of the e-commerce wave that is setting in into our country? In the US, of course, is far more conspicuous than India. What is your take?
See, the whole adoption of e-commerce is fairly new.
Yeah.
I think particularly...
New to India, I guess.
In India, yes. It's sort of really taking off. But we work with a number of large retailers in the US.
Sure.
And what is becoming more popular is the whole notion what you call omni-channel, where people would still love to come and see physical goods in the stores, but they'd like to complete the transaction online. So the future, as at Mindtree we see it, is I think traditional retailers are also going to depend a lot on the online channel for connecting with their consumers, as well as completing the sale.
Sure.
But at the same time, that does not do away with the physical brick and mortar store. So it is going to be a balance of both brick and mortar stores as well as online stores. But certainly the mix of business which comes from the brick and mortar is going to reduce, and the online channel is going to become much larger. That does not necessarily mean there are only going to be the Amazon type of online stores which are going to survive.
Sure.
I think you're going to, even Amazon, I think at some time, for some parts of their business, could think of bringing in physical stores.
Oh, really? So you'll see eBays and Flipkarts and Amazons of the world going to brick and mortar with a nice mix, and the regular brick and mortar starting
to get into,
more into e-commerce. So we're going to see a mix of both worlds.
Absolutely.
Rather. But how long before this 50% here and 50% there transaction transformation rather really takes place?
See, at Mindtree, we see that happening over the next 3 to 5 years, which is why retail is a very, very important segment for Mindtree. In fact, in the last 8 quarters, that's been one of our fastest growing segments.
Sure.
So we are putting in a lot of investments to build both intellectual property as well as solutions to really help retailers transition this whole omni-channel sort of thing. So the vision is a consumer should come to a physical store, he sees something, he sort of says, okay, I want to buy this, but then later on he goes home, probably shows to others in the family.
And the transaction gets completed online.
And the transaction really gets done.
Really? Nice. Time now for me to play my chip
shot
and we continue.
Right. Yeah.
New technologies such as cloud, you've got analytics, you've got mobile, so much is gaining ground in India now. But really, organizations are suffering. You know, there is a lack of skill set, there is inflexible legacy systems, you've got lack of budget, you know, there's resistance to new technology adoption as well. What is really the problem? What is the crux of this issue? Why aren't they being able to adopt these technologies in much more efficient manner?
See, I think the scenario sometime back where people were looking at each of these technologies as very discrete pieces.
Right.
Somebody was looking at mobility, was only looking at mobility.
Sure.
There's somebody looking at cloud. But the real value to the business comes when you really start looking how each can leverage your end outcome to the customer. I think it is really going to be how businesses understand the cross leverage of each of these technologies and then see it in a business context. How is it going to create a difference for my customer, my consumer? And those are the companies which are going to win in the marketplace. The ones which sort of get overawed by it because the technology is very complex, they're going to lose out.
All right, so leveraging the power of big data, analytics, mobile and various technology is what we're talking about with the Managing Director and CEO of Mindtree. Stay with us. We're going to take a break. We will see you on the other side. Welcome back. You're still tuned into Tea Time. And we're in conversation with the Managing Director and CEO of Mindtree. And on this segment, let's just talk about the Internet of Things. Now, Gartner predicts that by the year 2020, we're going to have more than 80 billion connected devices. Now, that's right. A huge figure.
Absolutely.
Is this going to impact the way we're seeing service and delivery in the sector?
Absolutely. I think at Mindtree, we are very excited of the potential of Internet of Things. And since we do a lot of work on the embedded software side, we have a lab where we're building in unique applications, which really thinks that every node is going to be on the internet, which really means you can take in data out of that, you can analyze it, and then really give real-time feedback, which could extend to a number of things. It could happen in your homes where you could really say, okay, my refrigerator is really internet enabled. So you start from home, you really say, okay, I just want it to be switched on, or it could be your air conditioner, which could be done. Those are very simple consumer facing appliances. Two, you could get to the next complex level of thing where there is real time data which is coming in from devices. Based on analyzing that, you could take predictive action. So I think the potential and possibility with Internet of Things is really enormous. What is going to distinguish is really trying to understand what do you do with the humongous amount of data which is going to come in, how are you going to analyze it, and how are you really going to help make really predictive actions and real-time actions which will really help a business be more effective. That's really where we're focusing on.
So let's talk about Mindtree a little bit. Your outlook for the future, you are seeing demand improving. In fact, you're seeing a healthy pipeline from international geographies like US and Europe particularly. What is your outlook remain?
See, we remain very optimistic of the demand scenario for 2014. Very much in the context of a strategy change which we made to focus on a few verticals. We believe today we're really becoming experts in those segments. And consequently, if you look at our own growth rates over the last several quarters, we have been very much on the top quartile of growth. With that, we believe that this financial year, we will beat the NASSCOM estimates of 12-14%. As well as next year, we believe we're very optimistic in terms of how our growth is going to be. I do think at some time, the market used to perceive us as being one of the best mid-sized companies. Sure. Increasingly, we think we are becoming what one would call the rising star of the IT industry. Because our growth has been consistent, we've been delivering very good. The type of customers and the marquee customers who are becoming our customers and becoming more long-term with us is improving. So overall, we do think over the next 3 to 5 years, we would certainly focus on these verticals which we have chosen to focus and become experts in that and gain leadership position. That's really the objective which we're pushing.
So you do maintain a very high operating leverage as well. You did see a bit of margin expansion recently, but that was moreover because of the currency benefits that you got as well. Do you see some sort of margin compression going forward on the back of wage increases at Mindtree?
See, what would happen is many times these tend to follow quarterly sort of patterns.
Absolutely.
But if you've seen over the last 8 quarters, we've consistently improved margins.
Sure.
We were at close to 11%, and over the last 3-4 quarters, we've been consistently been around 20% EBITDA margin level, which we think is what we will sort of aim to get at. So typically in a quarter where there is a wage increase, you could see a margin drop. Mm-hmm. But once the wage increase is absorbed and growth comes back, it has the ability to bring back the margin. So our whole sort of approach to business is, I think we need to do the right investments for the business so that growth really is at industry leading levels. And wherever I think we need to do necessary cost structure changes like wage increase or investment in a large facility, we'll do it. But still, in a 1 or 2 quarters, we'll get back to the margin levels at which we are comfortable with.
Okay, so now good time now for us to talk about golf and you. Mm-hmm. How long have you enjoyed the passion for this sport?
No, I've been playing for almost 12 years now.
Really?
I think it also comes from a personal sort of drive. I try and see to learn new things every 5 to 10 years. So this passion for golf started when I said I should learn something new, because I've always played sports, but that was more table tennis and badminton. So I said I should play golf. And also because I think in the corporate world, I think you tend to get to new relationships. You sort of
Absolutely.
Get to meet new people playing golf.
I guess networking is almost incidental part of the game.
Absolutely. So I started this 12 years back and since then have really enjoyed it. It's really been something which keeps pushing you, because here you're really playing against your mind. You set your own improvement goals. You want to improve your handicap every week after week, year after year. So that way I think it's a great leveler.
How about Mindtree? How long before Mindtree organizes their own corporate golf challenge? Is there a culture of golf at Mindtree?
It's just picking up. I must tell you, I've sort of taken 4-5 years to bring in the first initial sense of interest in golf. But I'm sure it'll sort of pick up.
I mean, absolutely.
Yeah.
Come, let's finish our game.
Yeah. Nice putt.
Thank you. So what is really Krishna Kumar Natarajan's life mantra?
I think be focused, not give up. I think being an optimist all the time, because in building an institution like Mindtree, I think there have been several times where we've faced numerous challenges. But I think not giving up at every stage, believing in your idea and really working on it is one very key important thing. The second key thing is to really take people along.
Very well put. Thank you so much on that note for joining me on TeeTime.
Thank you.
So that's a wrap from me, Chaiti Narula, and Mr. Natarajan as well of Mindtree from Clover Greens right here in Bangalore. I will see you next week again. Until then, enjoy the flight of a good drive.